Hello friends, and today I'm joined with molecular scientist Bob Settineri. And we just got done with our first hydrogen water expo, and it was magnificent. You delivered so much great value to everybody there, inspired so many people.
Thank you.
And it's because of your research, it's because of your background. So will you tell the audience here why you decided that you want to write a book about hydrogen?
Okay. So I was pretty excited about biology almost all my life since I was a little kid, and I gained more and more experience in research and studied to go to high school, college and graduate school, and got, you know, more involved in microbiology and immunology, and then the research led to studying cells. And I made films about cells, and that took me to the next field where I thought maybe, you know, good products that are natural that affect cells would be great. So we did some research, hands-on, with my colleagues, and we published some studies on hydrogen, and that led me to write this book.
Wonderful. And so tell us a little bit about the pharmaceutical drug companies you used to work with, and you know, knowing what you know now, both hydrogen and, you know, there's drug therapies, would you say that hydrogen is more powerful in some ways than other traditional ways of treating yourself or certain things like diabetes?
Yeah, well, it depends on the condition of the person, but overall, you have natural supplements or natural products or nutrients like hydrogen that are very safe and still very effective with a lot of research behind it. And then you have pharmaceuticals, which are made more of a synthetic level that the body doesn't really recognize off the bat, but they can, for the right condition, they can do a world of good. So it's a combination. Now there's some integrative professionals that use natural therapies more than say drugs and vice versa, but I think the use of molecular hydrogen is very valuable because it has so many medical benefits, clinical benefits, 2,000 publications, and studied in about 170 disease conditions, which is quite impressive, quite expansive. So the research is ongoing, and there's more and more coming, and probably in a year from now, we'll probably have 3,000 or 4,000 studies because of the interest level is gaining. And in Korea, China, and Japan, there are medical facilities and even hospitals that use hydrogen for inhalation for severe cardiovascular problems, and they're seeing some good results.
Oxidative stress, that seems to be the thing that's behind every disease process. And so hydrogen acts as an antioxidant. Can you elaborate more on what that specifically means?
Yeah, I'm stressed out just by talking about oxidative stress. But the oxidative stress is caused by free radicals, some bad guys, they're bad molecules that can damage cells and tissue. And what hydrogen does, it can go after the very bad, it's selective, it goes after the bad free radicals and makes them harmless. And so that reduces oxidative stress dramatically. But lo and behold, hydrogen leaves the good guys alone because you need some of those free radicals, especially when the mitochondria produce energy. There's some free radical stuff, but they're good guys. So hydrogen leaves the good guys alone, makes them do what they do in the best way possible, which they do, and it goes after and neutralizes or makes the bad guys harmless. In fact, the worst free radical, it's called OH or hydroxide radical, when you add the H2, it turns the worst oxidative stressor into water. Now, no other antioxidant can do that.
And that's very powerful. You know, we have a water store and we see clients coming in all day long getting these therapeutic benefits you're talking about. Energy, sleeping patterns, skin tones, digestive issues. I mean, is there anything that hydrogen cannot do or help with?
Well, it's hard to say. 170 disease conditions is quite a few, but probably there will be more and more. And what's really good is to reevaluate and increase the amount of research on studies that have already been done and doing maybe in a little different way and finding out more and more information as time goes by. So we're in a way scratching the surface of what hydrogen can do. However, we found out a great deal. But being the simplest, most abundant molecule in the universe, the smallest, with all those wonders, it's quite impressive of all the conditions that it can help.
And we all drink water. You know, that's the thing. You can live 3 days without water, right? So we have the ability to choose. Do we want to drink tap water, bottled water, or you can drink hydrogen water, which has all these benefits. Like you said, over 2,000 studies now to date on these uses in the body with hydrogen. So I believe it's literally the simplest, most powerful thing that people can do every day to improve the quality of their health.
Yes, I agree. We should encourage people to find out more about it. And my book describes quite a bit about it, but that's not the only way you can get the information. You can actually go to PubMed or Google Scholar, or maybe even Google itself, and maybe type in what you're curious about. Like, for example, say you can type in skin appearance or skin health and molecular hydrogen. Google those few words, and you'll see many studies that support that one particular condition.
So if you're new to hearing about this information, this is a great tool here. You can find this book on our website. So I'd highly recommend that you read the book and try some hydrogen water. You know, it's fairly new here in the U.S., but it's been going on in the Asian markets for about how long, Bob?
Oh, geez, 17 years or so, something like that. I'm not exactly sure how long, but in actuality, there are hospitals and clinics that actually use hydrogen in the inhalation form through hydrogen gas through nasal cannulas. They can treat people with severe cardiovascular heart conditions, and they're seeing some very good results that are shown for years now in these clinics.
It's powerful. I know at our center we also have the inhalation, and we have the eye goggles for eye health too. And just to see the improvement in people's bodies is just one of the most rewarding things, and yet it's so simple. So thank you so much for writing this book and giving us your time here today. So for all you out there, make sure you try hydrogen water and get a copy of this book yourself by clicking that link below. Until I see you, be happy, be healthy, and be free.